So far, 23 people have received decontamination treatment after being exposed to radiation. Reports say American troops are helping fight fires at the crippled nuclear plant. Japan's National Police Agency now saying at least 10,000 people are either dead or missing from the quake and the tsunami.
So for more on what's happening there in a quake reported only moments ago, David Piper is live at Yokota Air Base north of Tokyo. Did you feel the quake, David?
Hi, Bill. Yes, it was a very strong aftershock. The building I was standing in was rocking like a ship. We were actually live with Fox LA at the time, and I was giving them some commentary of what was happening. We didn't really know if it was another very big quake, but we do understand that there has been problems here, even in this area. The lifts of this building have now stopped, and if we want to evacuate this building, we'll have to use the fire escape. Let me give you the latest details I have also on the nuclear crisis. It does seem to be getting from bad to worse at this time. The Japanese government said earlier today there was a large radiation leak at that Fukushima plant. That's about 150 miles north of here, and the nuclear agency, IAEA, has said that radioactive cloud has been released from that unit. That's Unit 4, and we understand that the water pump of that same unit is not in operation this time. It's stuck. And what that means is that water can't get through, and the fuel rods of that Unit 4 are likely to be exposed even further at this time. And we understand that three of the four reactors at Fukushima are expelling some form of radiation. That's what the Japanese government has said to us. They have introduced a no-fly zone over that plant at this time, and they are warning any residents within a 20-mile radius that they must seal their homes, not go outside, and try to cover up to survive their ordeal. Back to you, Bill.
David Piper, thank you. North of Tokyo.